Meanwhile, businesses in Metro Manila expected to take another hit from tighter pandemic restrictions. The Philippine Trade Chief admits the shift to Alert Level 3 could affect up to 200,000 jobs. This report from Warren De Guzman.
Personal services, including barbershops, have once again been forced to limit their customers after the National Capital Region was returned to Alert Level 3. Barber Santos is more than disappointed. He is afraid this latest tightening might force his employer to close permanently.
Hindi na rin ako sang-ayon sa ganyan Alert Level 3 na yan kasi lalong-lalo na vaccinated na tayong nakabakuna na tayo eh, pero bakit kailangan pang ibalik yan mga yan? Sabi dati, pag nakabakuna ka na, pwede ka nang gumala.
After having experienced a bit more freedom during the fourth quarter of 2021, many loathed the return to a tighter alert level. The Federation of Filipino-Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry Incorporated fears small and medium businesses enticed to reopen because of the momentum experienced in the fourth quarter may be the first victims of this latest tightening, especially if they don't have enough capital. But the FFCCCII believes the government won't allow more businesses to close, having changed its COVID playbook. It also believes the Omicron variant is less deadly and therefore less troublesome.
The good thing is that they're not making it indefinite. They're now doing it in 2-week segments, which means that they're taking a very calibrated approach, a very logical approach.
But the Employers Confederation of the Philippines still expects businesses to take a hit, especially those forced to take in less customers, such as restaurants and malls.
Marami na naman yung maguguto, marami na naman yung mawawala ng trabaho. Una-una, yung mga non-essentials na mga ano, mga nagtatrabaho pa sa nasa probinsya yan eh. Pinatawag na yan, pumapasok na yan mga yan. Uuwi na naman. Anong gagawin dito sa Manila? Wala namang ayuda yan mga yan.
Trade Secretary Ramon Lopez says the higher alert level could cause as much as 200,000 workers to lose their jobs. But he notes the differences between alert level 2 and 3 are quite small and many businesses will still be able to generate some income.
Itong maganda sa alert level system natin ngayon, it allows all businesses to continue to operate, no? Maliban lang doon sa yung hindi na in-exclude natin. Yung pinaka-importante dito ay yung mailayo na natin yung ating bansa sa posibleng biglang pagdami ng Omicron cases.
Labor Secretary Sylvester Bello adds the government is prepared to provide affected workers financial aid, including an emergency employment or cash for work program for up to 40,000 informal workers and the COVID-19 adjustment measures program, which will give formal workers a one-time cash assistance worth 5,000 pesos.
Ang magbibigay ng pangalan ay yung mga employers. Ibibigay sa amin yung pangalan nila. And after they give us the name of their employees who will be temporarily displaced, ibibigay namin yung sweldo nila o yung cash assistance sa kanilang employer at ang employer ang magbibigay doon sa kanyang empleyado. Kung gusto naman nila, we can send it immediately.
Bello says over 100 employers have already applied for assistance through CAMP, but he expects that number to grow. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.